Hello friends, welcome to this second video in our Google Cloud Platform Beginner series. In this video, we'll quickly understand about different products which Google Cloud Platform offers. So if we have to divide Google Cloud Platform products and services, we can divide it into four different major categories, that is compute, storage, big data, and artificial intelligence, which is AI. Under compute, we have four different major products which are being offered. Now, if you see, I have highlighted all these products with a key highlighted in red. This is to give you a gist, a very high level context of what it offers. So Compute Engine, as the name suggests, offers a platform to run your virtual machines, your virtual servers on Google Cloud. So suppose if you have a server sitting in-house and if you want to deploy a similar server on Google Cloud, you would use Compute Engine to do so. It is very straightforward, so we'll quickly move on to Kubernetes. I have created a separate video on Kubernetes and container technologies, so go watch it. Google has its own GKE, Google Kubernetes Engine, which is inbuilt and which offers Kubernetes technology to all the Google Cloud customers. Using GKE, Google Kubernetes Engine, you can run containerized application on Google Cloud. Moving on, App Engine. As the name suggests, again, it is an application engine where you can deploy your web applications, your large-scale applications without any headache of managing the backend infrastructure. So suppose you want to develop a customized website for your customer which runs a business selling products online. You can deploy this whole website with various different options around languages like Go, Python, Java, .NET. All these languages can be used and that application can be developed and that can be easily deployed and scaled on App Engine. You have to spend nothing on infrastructure. It is a managed service where all the infrastructure is managed by Google Cloud from the backend. Cloud Functions, also on similar lines, works pretty much similar to an App Engine. So Cloud Functions and App Engines are quite similar, but what is the basic difference? Cloud Function also lets you deploy your application onto it, but it is meant mostly for single purpose lightweight application, whereas an app engine is meant for complex and large scale applications. So suppose if your application has various modules integrating with each other, then App Engine is a correct product for you. But if you want to deploy a single purpose function, suppose if you have if you want to write a program which fetches the data from one of your drives and from your CSVs, runs it, massages that data, and then load it into a database, then mainly you are focusing on something like Cloud Function, because it is a lightweight technology which can quickly help you deploy your single purpose function. So that is your whole overall compute platform, and these are the four major services provided under this category. Moving on, storage. Now, this is the USP of Google Cloud, because ever since Google came into the market, its storage, how it processes the data, has always been its USP. Under Google Cloud Storage Service, we have various services, various products provided to crunch your data, to massage your data, to store your data. So let's understand how it is done. The first major product provided under storage is Bigtable. And as I have highlighted, this is a NoSQL database. So people who don't know NoSQL database, just from a layman perspective, it is a NoSQL database where you cannot apply the concepts of a traditional relational databases. So data which is not structured, which is big data, which is sparsely populated, which is not ACID compliant, all such kind of data can be stored in a Bigtable or any other big data database. Moving on, cloud storage. I have highlighted this as a drive because you can simply consider cloud storage as your C or D drive on your laptop. It is an object store where you can store all kind of objects like images, files, Excel, CSV, whatever files, images you want to store, you can store under cloud storage. It has a concept of buckets. So within storage, you have multiple buckets, like you have folders within a drive, and within those folders or within those buckets, you can store your files, images, whatever. So it is pretty straightforward. It is also gives you exabyte of capacity. So capacity wise, all these products are very, very good. Cloud SQL. Now this can be easily relatable because Cloud SQL is a relational database product, which can be easily correlated with our day-to-day relational database like Oracle, MySQL. So it is very simple. All the relational database needs can be fulfilled by Cloud SQL. Obviously, Cloud SQL has some limitations in terms of how much data it can process because it is based on MySQL database. But yes, it is very, very efficient if your data needs are not very huge and if you want to run your relational database loads and if you want to do your database analysis, relational database analysis, then Cloud SQL is a good product. Cloud Spanner. Cloud Spanner can be considered as a big brother for Cloud SQL. So Cloud Spanner is a relational database with big data capabilities. So you can consider it as if you combine Cloud SQL and big table capabilities, that makes a Cloud Spanner. So Cloud Spanner is similar to Cloud SQL with massive scale and massive capabilities to run big data loads with SQL support. So Cloud Spanner should be your go-to product if you have massive database needs with massive amount of data and massive performance, but you have a relational database and you have a relational data which needs to be uploaded or used in Google Cloud Platform, then Cloud Spanner is a product for you. But for every normal database needs, you can go with Cloud SQL. Cloud Data Store is, again, you can say, is a subset of Bigtable, because what Bigtable cannot provide is somewhat provided by Cloud Data Store. So Cloud Data Store sits on top of Bigtable technology, but with slight SQL support. Although it is a NoSQL database, it still gives you some flexibility of using SQL and do your analysis using SQL queries. So that is the major difference between Bigtable and Cloud Data Store. Again, friends, we are not going into very deep details of these products because it would be really impossible in one video. So in future videos, we'll target every product and every service one by one, and we'll take various use cases and we'll understand it one by one. Moving on, the next category, which is again a very famous category, is big data. So big data, in under big data, the most famous product, which is the USP of Google Cloud, is BigQuery, because BigQuery is Google Cloud Platform's data warehouse solution where you can run your data analytics and data loads, and you can store your massive amount of data under data warehouse. So whatever data warehouse or data lake needs you have, you can get it fulfilled by using BigQuery. If you don't know about data lake, please go and check out my video which I have made on the same topic. PubSub. This is an interesting name, and this particular technology is used to ingest streaming data into the Google Cloud Platform. Imagine a server which is running and generating logs every few milliseconds, and those logs needs to be captured and analyzed. So in that case, PubSub is a very good middleware which can sit between that particular source which is generating huge amount of data every second. So that is a streaming data, live data. And PubSub can make sure that that data can be fetched from that source and ingested into Google Cloud Platform. So it is kind of a middleware which sits between source and GCP, which is Google Cloud Platform. Dataflow. Dataflow can simply be considered as an ETL product, like any other ETL product, Informatica, DataStage, SAP Data Services. This also helps you extract, transform, and load data. It helps you extract batch data and the streaming data at the same time, and you can create data flows within GCP, and you can process your data and massage your data and then load it into the target. So this is pretty much what an ETL tool does. So if you want to anytime understand data flows, you can simply correlate with an ETL product. Data catalog. Data catalog again is a metadata management service. So as you know, you need to know your metadata in order to understand what is floating around your cloud platform. So if you want to understand what is there in your data warehouse or in your data lake, then your metadata management has to be top notch. Else, as I have explained in my data lake video, your data lake can very quickly become a data swamp if you do not have a proper metadata management. So that's why data catalog is a very, very efficient technology and product to make sure that you manage your metadata properly. So moving on to the last category, which is artificial intelligence. Under this, we have multiple products provided. So all these products are basically based on different auto ML models, which is automatic machine learning models, which are developed by GCP and are readily available for the business to utilize. So the first one in this category is natural language API. And this is a very famous product to do sentiment analysis. Sentiment analysis can be quickly understood by an example of doing Twitter analysis during an election poll. By reading the Twitter messages and tweets, you can understand which particular party is leading, which party has a better chance of winning. So all these kind of analysis can be done using a machine learning model which is provided by natural language API. And by the way, if you don't know API, I again have made a separate video on API, so go check that out. Vision API. As the name suggests, this particular API and machine learning model helps you read images. So if I upload an image under Vision API, by just reading that image, the GCP platform can help you identify the data points which are related to that particular image. So it is very, very efficient for image data processing. Speech API, this again helps in converting your speech. So suppose someone is speaking and at the same time you want that particular speech to be converted into a text, then that in that case this particular API and machine learning model comes handy and it helps you do that analysis. Translate API. So this again is self-explanatory. Translate API helps you convert one particular language into another. So suppose you have something written in Chinese, you can feed that into this Translate API and it can convert it into English or any other language of your choice. So all these APIs and all these machine learning models needs data to train itself. Any machine learning model cannot work unless it has a training data, and based on that only it can run those statistics and come out with some predictive analysis. One very good product which has been added recently is video translation API, which helps you see a video and then that particular machine learning model can translate and take the data points coming out of that video during runtime. So that is also a very, very good product which has recently come up. Apart from this, we have the support components within the platform, which is your billing. Also, you have IAM, which is identity and access management, which we will cover in a separate video. We also have networking. We also have third-party vendors which have partnered with Google Cloud Platform. So when you will log in and when you will open your Google Cloud console, on the left hand side you'll see all these products and services lined up. Again, there are different ways to utilize this all these platforms. We will again cover it in a different video. So guys, if you like this video, please go and subscribe my channel. Also hit a like and share this video with your friends and colleagues. Thank you so much.